We have a huge problem and we need a solution. After hearing and reading about all these horrible statistics, and I hope they are horrible for you, because they are to me, I've decided to move from the back seat of my car to the front seat of the car, from the driver's seat, and launch a healthcare plan that will be adopted in Kenya University Project Medical Hospital Plan. In partnership with the Kenyans in the diaspora and also Kenyans in Kenya, my experience in the healthcare sector will look at implementing a system that intends to improve the healthcare of millions of Kenyans while benefiting us here in the diaspora and fulfill our dreams to save lives. As I was thinking through this plan, I was wondering whether any of you would ask this question. Would you rather have a John Hopkins prepared surgeon or a Harvard trained surgeon operating on you or on your loved one, or would you like Ogawari Rimo to perform your procedure? You don't have to answer me that. It's with a clear understanding that we have very big hospital plans and system in Kenya that continue to have increased infections, decreased patient satisfaction, high death rates, and I intend to implement a plan that defeats all those things. I intend to increase the number of properly trained clinicians and government officials who can be able to figure it out in the, almost like two sentences, one more should not be practicing on those women doing the horrible things that he's doing and letting go our world's smile. I plan to advocate for the government to implement systems that are going to fight for our people. Make sure that we have rules and regulations, certifications. Remember, I told you there was something behind those certifications. I cannot practice in the United States or touch your finger if I have not been certified or regulated to touch your finger. That's what we want in Kenya. I also intend to make sure that the voice of the people are heard and made a priority. From the time you enter to this facility to the time you departure, from sickness to wellness, and for some of us, unfortunately, to death. But I want to make sure in each and every one of those steps that I implement what we need. By working with several vulnerable populations here in the United States and also in Africa, I've been engaged and collaborated with a lot of communities and served for patients' rights. Most of us have heard that patients do have right to quality care and access to healthcare resources. For these and many other related issues, I will not allow the institution plan to take any more chances, but to do the right thing. Therefore, the professional excellence acquired by my team will see and create and adopt the strongest plan there is in Africa. I joined Kenya University Project in 2013 to advance developer. I later on realized that a good house with a clean water and a good sanitation system is considered the first step in the healthcare system. I then progressed, so it started with the Kenya University Project, that's where I started. Then I moved on to the hospital plan, which is the medical hospital plan. I can assure you that I'm very excited to my expertise into shaping the institution plan. On a daily basis, I always set a few hours to create the healthcare sciences and the hospital operational and management. to be implemented in this institution. I also intend to implement a case management plan, which I have been dreaming of for a long time. But it's all with an understanding that once implemented, the plan will play a crucial role in meeting and sustaining the institution and town needs of healthcare. I will not rest until the dream is finally arrived. Having led in ensuring life is sustained with good treatment every time a person presents to the hospital, I feel ready and equipped to the plan, to point the plan into the right direction and visualize a successful beginning and future for Kenya University Project. In meeting the goals of the institution plans that strives to achieve a town with over 30,000 residents, 10,000 students, and a strong medical hospital plan, I plan to establish the health sciences department at the institution, the hospital operation and management plan, as well as create a case management plan. The hospital operation and management plan will be designed to take care of the sick or injured person from the time of entry to the hospital. I want to make sure from the time you walk into that door and get registered at triage, screened by the driver, get a diagnosis, that you're going to be able to safely walk from that door and at the same time walk in the same door smiling because you've received the health care that you need. The success of an efficient and quality health care relies heavily on the operational and management plan that the interdisciplinary plan composed of medical doctors, licensed nurses, therapists, respiratory therapists, social workers, technicians, and many more are trained to operate, manage, and administer treatment like they should. So, I want to remind you that there's a reason that you're here today. Because you are very crucial to this plan, because it looks complicated, it looks so many things, you don't know what is hanging from where, but I want you sitting there today to look at yourself and see yourself somewhere in that plan, because I do believe you are somewhere in that plan. A little bit to explain on a different picture from the one I had before. We heard from Dr. Ndebe that we do have, we work with plans and projects. So, an issue, what I call my motherland, is the KPM degree plan. And then I fall under the medical hospital plan, which also is going to establish an institution plan. For us to be able to do that, we have all these other departments and plans that have to work with us for us to be able to succeed. Again, I want you to visualize that picture. Don't see the colors or anything else. Visualize yourself and tell me, is that what you want? Or do you want to continue to walk into more Ramos Clinic? Like Dr. Ndebe said, we have decided to create a little map. I worked a lot with maps, not with pictures. But this is what we're looking at. When I think of John Hopkins Hospital, where I work at, I walk into a garage. I don't have to go looking on the street for parking space. From there, I want to make sure I'm walking to a building, nice building. So we are planning to have a building, nice spacing, several buildings. We want to make sure our doctors or what I would call the professional offices are well there. But in the middle, when we're waiting for patients to have surgery or waiting for a lab to come up, we have a nice garden or food court that we all can meet and have a nice lunch. Because lunch is important in our health. In also doing that, we have to realize that you cannot succeed in a plan like this without skills and knowledge, usually obtained from higher education or diverse clinical practice and a great team. Also, the leadership of a strong, well-established professional is a necessity. In addition, an expert or clinicians with dreams and believe that all healthcare should be preventable, accessible, and affordable is a plus. In this room today, we are surrounded with people full of dreams, goals, and great qualifications. Allow me to show you part of my team that is working with me to create the healthcare system that we want to share. I feel very honored to be a part of such a great team that share the same goals of creating a healthcare system similar to the one that I'm used to here, that I enjoy here. We have refused to sit back and wait for the healthcare change on its own, but to take a first front seat to make sure that no one at all is denied access to health services due to factors such as lack of money, insurance, or even our ethnic background.